Hey guys, welcome back. And we're doing now this Operation Stormfest. Difficulty easy. So, no trouble at all, right? Dude, this guy's beard, holy shit. Pretty sure they're all like random characters, but yeah.
Communications with resistance forces in the area have gone dark, which can only mean one thing. These people sacrificed everything to give us this shot. We need to recover that converter at all costs.
So if you were starting the game without the tutorial, this is pretty much where the game would kind of drop you off at, which is still basically a tutorial because these missions are worthless.
But it looks like it may have been damaged during the fight. Energy readings are going crazy. I'm guessing we don't have much time before it explodes. Shen's working on a way to stabilize that thing, provided we can get close enough to access its core. Stay in the shadows until we can get a better read on the situation. Stepping off.
Sir. We're now doing concealment in an actual mission, so you get a better idea of how this would normally work. So you generally, how it wants to, when you were in XCOM 1, you'd basically just be, being cautious as fuck going to all this. Now you kind of don't, just for the beginning part.
No need to ask.
So
twice.
I'm able to sprint over, as long as, I'm in cover and I don't get, flanked, then it's fine. So I can just keep going up and up, and then that's the thing is when you move up, you want to stop in a place where there's cover. So for example, I'm gonna stop here, and hopefully we don't see anything.
The advanced officers seem more capable than the grunts. We're not sure whether to chalk it up to training or stricter mind control. Commander, we have a chance to do some serious damage here. Before jumping into combat, let's make sure we make the most of our advantage.
I'm gonna move this guy here. The only thing is, if you sprint into a situation if there was let's say a soldier over here, then you'd see me obviously. It's kind of weird. You just have to kind of know what's coming up, but it allows a little bit more strategy, which is nice. That the game kind of at least the original XCOM lacked. So as long as they're in cover, it's fine. Which helps for a mission like this where I'm trying to get a bomb, right? So these guys are just patrolling and don't see anything I'm doing. Now, this is not actually that great for me because they're kind of they're in a weird spot. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna move this guy up into here.
Already there.
I want Jane to be really close.
Objective. Okay, you should be able to hack into that thing's safety protocols and stabilize it. Shen is uploading the fix right now.
So, the problem is, if I go up here, judging by the sight lines, he might move up here and then I might get caught during this next part, so I may not want to go up there. But we're going to yellow. I'm also going to show you something else that's actually a pretty interesting mechanic.
Moving out.
So I'm making them all overwatch right now, but despite the fact they are going to move, I'm not actually going to be breaking overwatch because we're still in concealment. So the mechanic actually works much nicer than you guys would think. So I say it's basically time to break overwatch, but there's also a guy over here that is actually a problem. So I actually can't keep this guy here. He's going to have to move somewhere else. Potentially right over here, to be honest. Boom, here first.
Designated coordinates.
Question is, does he have a shot on anybody? And the answer is no.
I'm on it.
I think Jane should move up, though.
I'm on it.
If Jane goes over here, yeah, she should be fine. So they'll only break overwatch if we're revealed. Yeah, there's two here. So this is probably the least ideal situation because we're gonna be dealing with four of them at once as soon as I break concealment here. Maybe those guys will fuck off though. And he's gonna just hug the wall there. Yeah, I don't know. The thing is, I also want to break concealment in such a way... Yeah, we don't have much time. We're kind of short on time here. We're going to want to break concealment in such a way where... Okay, here's what we're going to do. Move this guy up to the trees. And move the other two schmucks a little bit like over here. And we will break concealment no matter what next turn. Because we have to get this shit show on the road.
Location confirmed.
Also, still no option to undo your turn, so if you do a massive fuck-up, then... Okay, these guys are coming towards me now. Yeah, we are definitely... We may have actually already broke it, because they may see this guy.
Commander, we're running out of time here. If we don't stabilize the converter soon, I don't think anybody's going home today.
Alright. We're gonna do Overwatch. Overwatch. This one is gonna throw a grenade at them, I think. Unfortunately, and the thing is, we also have one really, really great shot to make on somebody. So it's one or the other, because they're not in cover or anything. I think we're gonna go with the ladder. We're gonna try and make one really good shot on the commander there, because now, like we're as close as possible. We can do this. We'll let the bearded guy do it, and 3 damage. So as you expect, we break it. And since they're out in the open, our concealment. How did you miss? Alright, so. So there we go with that. And then these two schmucks can see us now. Look, there's Jared. Alright.
Rangers are uniquely equipped for close quarters combat. In the right situation, it can prove highly effective.
So this mechanic is the slash mechanic. It does like 3 to 5 damage, but I have to move to their place. It also works as if like I'm doing a sprint move. It's essentially the equivalent of run and gun. But what we're actually going to do is we're going to use her to flank over here, which I actually may not be able to. I may just be slightly short on movement points. I was actually thinking I was going to get a flank off, but apparently not. So I can either move her really far back or into here or something. I think what I'm actually going to do is only Jane. So I think I'm just going to actually toss a grenade. Maybe. Because that'll blow up his cover and make him hurt or something, I think. But honestly, that's not looking too good. I was hoping we would get more out of this, to be honest. But we really didn't. Because I want to get a flank off on some of these guys. Like, I thought I was actually in range of that. It's 67% isn't actually a good chance to hit these guys. But they're gonna flank me if I don't flank them. Man, I wish we had run and gun and that double shot ability. Oh, that shit was the best. We're already nostalgic for XCOM 1. No, I'm just joking. It's fine. We're gonna toss a grenade. I've changed my mind. I think it still works like the other game where it's like... So it looks like right now it's like... It's still kind of precision tile shit. Like it's kind of weird how it works now. I can't really describe the grenades that well. I think they've gotten rid of the precision tile shit. So I think I don't have much of a choice. We're just going to have to shoot this guy. Hey, it worked out. One guy's still going to get flanked. Probably her or something. If this guy's not a moron. I mean, he's behind a tree, which is full cover. Yeah, he's a smart fella. Goodbye, rookie. I know, only 3 damage, actually. Hey, he pointed to him. He's like, hey, that guy's fucking me. Okay, so she's marked back here. Kind of a weird target to mark. Okay. Alright, so... Now here's the thing, I can move him here and then shoot this guy point blank. Alternatively, we can do something maybe potentially smarter than that.
Moving out.
This is what I'm thinking we do. Fucking rearrange some architecture.
Take this!
That works. Let's see. So we can do that. So let's see what Jane says with regards to her sorting action. So it's like a little bit more of a guaranteed hit, but it may not kill them. That's what we're afraid of, but we want to see some sword action, don't we? What kind of cover will she take? So she'll try and take the smart cover when she's there. Unfortunately, the real problem is when she gets there, there could be someone there. So it's not actually an action we really want to take. That's the problem. So what we're going to actually do is we're going to move this guy here. We're going to try and kill this guy. Alright, we got him. I mean, there's a time and place for that sword ability, and I don't think this is the time or the place. And he's dead.
Got him.
Alright, we got two turns to disable that guy. Oh, look, he's got his ass promotion. Alright, we gotta basically go now to this thing and hack it. So normally we'd be able to hack it there, but you need to basically spend a turn doing that, so I'm gonna have to run her up and hope for the best. Oh hey, look, there's more aliens. Fuck.
Although they bear some resemblance to the sectoids first encountered during the invasion, their genetic structure now includes human DNA. They are stronger than ever, with an even greater psionic potential.
Alright, no idea what this fucking guy did. The fuck is this? Reanimated. Oh.
Respite for the dead. The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Oh, there you go. He's alive again. The motherfucker. And now she's dead. You know what? Fuck this. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna move her into that, because that's probably what I should have done to begin with. I kind of jumped the gun. And I forgot I would have an extra move to go hack it right after the fucking after I killed the guy, so. Because I saw the timer having two turns on it, so let's do this again. I'm going to do the exact same thing, by the way. This is the right one. You don't want to lose missions, right? And this is before we rearrange architecture, so do it again. It was a good strategy with the grenades and stuff, but I may have prematurely just jumped the gun a bit on the getting to the hacking thing. I'll tell you where I was gonna bring her. I was gonna bring her over here instead. Oh, he's dead again. Yeah, I love the backflip.
Hostiles pacified.
Alright. So with her, I want to bring her over here. Here's the problem, you bring them over there. See what I mean? I wouldn't have enough space. I'd have to sprint her anyways. So what we'll do is, I think we do have to honestly bring her somewhere restrained, like over here.
Moving to designated coordinates.
We didn't trigger them this time, I think.
Commander, the converter is near
collapse. What I mean. It's like one turn. Alright, let's start with hacking the thing again. We go over here. We piss off the aliens? No, we didn't piss them off.
Might be something interesting here.
Alright, Jane's once again not a very good hacker. Research time on current tech reduced by 50%. Or a soldier's hacking stack permanently increased by 20%, but it's like the chance to get is like nothing. Yeah, like literally luck. Like no rewards. She's not very good at it. What can you say?
Package in tow.
Well done. Readings are returning to normal. Well, mostly normal. Firebrand is en route, but I wouldn't take any chances. Eliminate all remaining hostiles in the area before evac.
Come get some.
Affirmative. Covering now.
So apparently that hack took her turn up. Interestingly enough. Well, we did it, so it's all good.
Some resemblance to the sectoids first encountered during the invasion. Their genetic structure now includes human DNA. They are stronger than ever, with an even greater psionic potential.
Moving to position!
Alright, we can see that one, we can see that one. I mean, that's not the worst chance to hit in the world that I've seen, so. He's definitely going to be overwatching, I think, over there. One of them is over here, so they can easily flank our lovely lady.
That's
here.
Affirmative.
So...
got it covered.
I'm going to just scanning. Let them kind of walk into us. The problem is over here, you won't get a shot on anything. We may want to move up there, but that's not exactly a great spot either. I think over here is honestly our best bet.
Will do.
Although you won't be able to make any actions.
Got it covered.
Okay, so the soldier, the shotgunners always take a really long range shot still.
Target's still up.
It's fucking great. Yeah, he did the same thing this time. This is actually the first time I've seen this. It's actually a pretty interesting mechanic. So you have to worry about this.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Mind control the dead. Alright, so we've got one guy overwatching. And this schmuck is moving up. Apparently we didn't get a shot on him, though. Oh, this poor guy. Alright. So we have either Psy Zombie, or that guy, or that guy. Well, we have a couple targets here. What does Jane see? Oh, that's a good shot. I like that guy. Fuck. I now regret not moving her. We are totally gonna blow up that fucking car. Apparently she needs ammo too. Alright, we need to throw a grenade at this guy.
Grenade.
I mean, I know that's that. I'm gonna handle that Psy soldier with the two soldiers that are behind there. At least he'll have to move, I figure. Psy zombie or that guy. Let's kill the Psy zombie. Nice aim. Let's just finish that guy off. So, as far as I can tell, I think we don't have pistols on guys, except when they're like a sharpshooter or something. It's a bit of an odd mechanic. I'll double check it when we get into this. Oh, this guy's fucking sprinting. Alright, we gotta handle this guy. And she's mind controlled, so now we definitely have to take care of him. And now they're hyper aggressive. Looks like we're gonna lose Jane, which I kind of didn't want to happen. Oh no, she's fine. Apparently.
Fire in the zone.
All right. And that guy's dead. So, throw a grenade at his ass. Remove his fucking tree cover. Why can't he throw it? I'm trying to click there, and then. He's not able to throw it, actually. Apparently that's out of range, I guess. So we're gonna just have to move up slightly. Because we don't want to deal with our fucking soldiers being mind controlled. Wow, look at that. So apparently we can't see it. Okay. And here's the other problem. We don't want to get fucking killed by this guy. So... we're in trouble now, I think. We are definitely in trouble. This guy did not move. Oh wait, we can remove his full cover. We can remove his cover at least. Maybe we can't. Oh well, it became half cover. That's what we did with that. So we can go up to him and sword his ass, but I mean that's not exactly the best idea right now. I think we may be losing one of these rookies. Just gonna have to put up with them. Those guys are a big ass problem. I'm gonna tell you that now. I was hoping that grenade would put enough of a dent in that tree. But I guess the distance to the tree really matters. I don't know, we don't seem to have any options here. I'm gonna just hide behind this hack thing. That guy's so dead though. Alright, you see, if I overwatch, then we'll lose this person, so... I'll just go for the Jesus shot. Yeah, that's a miss.
Target's still up. Draining ammo fast.
Rip.
Casualty here.
The soldier. Poor guy. Killed by his own fellow squaddy. Oh, apparently he can just kind of run out in the open here. And he can take shots at me while mind controlling. You'll learn something. That was a really bad idea then. I shouldn't have gone over there then. That's something new. Already, the second mission, and we're losing a ton of people. Well, actually, you know what? I actually now kind of have a chance to move up a little bit closer to get a full grenade off. So there is that. I'm pretty sure the only way to break this meld thing is that we have to make sure he goes down. I mean, as I said, we could do some cool fucking katana shit, but... Actually, you know what? Maybe we will do cool katana shit. We'll see how that works out. Because this guy can actually kill this one. Actually, maybe it was a good idea that I did this, because then I can kind of rethink this.
Weapons burning ammo fast.
Alright. Yeah, there's absolutely no way we're going to get a shot off, because over here it's like no range. However, we can go up to him and sword him. That's the thing. Now, it's like really unlikely we're going to get him, but fuck it. Okay. That was like the luckiest shit ever. Someone definitely deserved to die on this mission. Even before safe's coming.
Got the goods.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Alright, well, I'm not even gonna fucking pretend that wasn't complete luck. But yeah. We were in a bad spot, and I had no idea the guy would just move around and kill me. I guess they, yeah, that's right, they did do that in the first game. It's just, I would never let them get fucking mind-controlled all the time. I'd just, like, snipe them or something. It's something I had to play around with a whole lot. We did it, guys. We won. Alright, back to base then.
A few of our people earned well-deserved promotions, Commander.
Gravely wounded.
I'm guessing Shan will probably want to have a word with you too.
Yeah, it looks like they're having issues. Alright, let's see what Thomas becomes.
Serving as our demolitions experts, the Grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
It's got like a bowl cut, it's terrible. Anyways, yeah, that's the replacement for the Rocketeer. It's actually a really good change, I'd say. Just because you can equip the grenades and then they can use the grenades in their grenade launcher, apparently, so... They fire grenades rather than throwing them, so you get more grenades and shit out of that, which is nice. So let's see what... And here
just
we have
like
our sharpshooter.
Our sharpshooters engage enemy targets with pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
And there's this guy. So he's got squad sight as the first ability, so they did take something from Long War after all, which is good. But it's been nerfed in this game. I guess maybe some abilities make it better, but we don't know yet. Basically, the major change is that squad sight still works like the first game. Like, you can basically have unlimited sight as long as someone sees you and you have line of sight. Only difference now is if you're too far away, the chance to aim actually degrades, so you can't have them literally on the other side of the map taking shots. Apparently. so much for sniping. Oh well. But it's still pretty good. It's good as a first ability, I'd say. And I'm hoping some of these unlocks make it even better, so we'll see. And here's our last guy.
Off
operating some of our most advanced equipment. Specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
So these guys can either be your medics or just like specialist kind of guys. So aid protocol is essentially gives a defense bonus to whoever you want. It's like a 20 defense bonus. It's actually quite nice, actually. I like that one. He's a good class.
These items should prove useful in our ongoing efforts against the aliens. When you have a moment, Commander, I have made some interesting discoveries as they relate to the implant we removed from you earlier.
Why are you all just standing around? It's perfect. Come on, let's get it inside.
Hey, to engineering then.
Okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander. I can't promise any miracles, Commander, but I should be able to put some of the stuff together in no time at all. I'd suggest we get started with the med kit. It'll probably come in handy sooner rather than later. I'm on it, Commander.
Looks like Tigan has made progress on his research. We should meet him in the lab.
So much of my own research based upon this simple design. If only I had known. Ah, Commander, excellent timing. There's been some progress. I've managed to break down several key components of the chip implanted into your skull. My analysis reveals that its primary function was that of a conduit, passing a vast amount of data directly to your cerebral cortex. With the primary connection severed, much of that data is lost. Several fragments do remain, however, ghosts, if you will. Observe. Tactical combat simulations. War games. The sheer volume of encounters you were processing was astounding. It is truly remarkable that you survived as long as you did. Though this may seem disconcerting, there is still some good news. This chip bears a striking resemblance to a medical implant I briefly assisted in developing at the gene therapy clinic in New Providence. My understanding was that the implants were intended for high-ranking Advent officers only, captains or above. Retrieving a chip from such an officer would be the only way to know for certain. A greater understanding of these implants would undoubtedly benefit us all, Commander.
New objective added.
All right.
The Advent officers have clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically. The implanted chip is the key.
So we can either do the autopsy or something else. I think, do you want to do officer autopsy? Sure.
The Advent officers appear to be similar, if not physically the same as the common Advent trooper in terms of power and agility. However, field reports indicate a more developed mental acuity, as the officers do provide tactical directives to the subordinate Advent forces. I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing options available. We'll begin work immediately. I'll send word when a complete report is available.
Looks like Shen got that converter up and running, Commander. We're ready for you on the bridge.
Just stay clear of the perimeter, understood?
Commander, good.
I think we got something here.
Despite all of Advent's efforts, there are still people who refuse to believe their lies. And it's time we let them know they're not alone. We've already located a target for our first operation.
Sir, given our current location, there's actually no way the Sky Ranger could reach that position.
Who said anything about the Sky Ranger? Shen, status report, are we ready?
Short answer, yes. But you might all want to hold on to something.
Precinct. Really, the entire time we were in India or something. Now we go back to America.
We're ready to start making moves, Commander. By hitting Advent wherever we find them, we can help strengthen the resistance. In return, they'll contribute material and personnel to support our operations.
So we get an engineer out of this. Literally nothing else, so.
Commander, it looks like Shen prepped a med kit for us. We should equip one of our soldiers with it before they deploy.
We will do that next time. But that's it for now, so take care, guys, and we will be watching.